Moby Dick, written by Herman Melville, narrated by Lu Bryan.
Moby Dick, or The Whale, by Herman Melville. Prologues. Etymology, supplied by a late consumptive usher to a grammar school. The pale usher, threadbare in coat, heart, body, and brain. I see him now. He was ever dusting his old lexicons and grammars with a queer handkerchief, mockingly embellished with all the gay flags of all the known nations of the world. He loved to dust his old grammars. It somehow mildly reminded him of his mortality. Quote, "While you take in hand to school others, and to teach them by what name a whale-fish is to be called in our tongue, leaving out through ignorance the letter H, which almost alone maketh the signification of the word, you deliver that which is not true." Hakluyt. Quote, "Whale, Swedish and Danish, val. This animal is named from roundness or rolling, for in Danish, hvalt is arched or vaulted." Webster's Dictionary. Quote, "Whale. It is more immediately from the Dutch and German valen, Anglo-Saxon valvian, to roll, to wallow." Richardson's Dictionary. Caetus, Greek. Caetus, Latin. Hvel, Anglo-Saxon. Hvalt, Danish. Val, Dutch. Val, Swedish. Vale, Icelandic. Whale, English. Baleine, French. Balena, Spanish. Pikinuinui, Fiji. Piki Nui Nui, Aromanguin. Extracts, supplied by a sub-sub-librarian. It will be seen that this mere painstaking burrower and grubworm of a poor devil of a sub-sub appears to have gone through the long Vaticans and street stalls of the earth, picking up whatever random allusions to whales he could anyways find in any book whatsoever, sacred or profane. Therefore you must not, in every case at least, take the higgledy-piggledy whale statements, however authentic, in these extracts, for veritable gospel cetology. Far from it. As touching the ancient authors generally, as well as the poets here appearing, these extracts are solely valuable or entertaining as affording a glancing bird's-eye view of what has been promiscuously said, thought, fancied, and sung of Leviathan by many nations and generations, including our own. So fare thee well, poor devil of a sub-sub, whose commentator I am. Thou belongst to that hopeless sallow tribe which no wine of this world will ever warm, and for whom even pale sherry would be too rosy strong, but with whom one sometimes loves to sit and feel poor devilish too, and grow convivial upon tears, and say to them bluntly, with full eyes and empty glasses, and in not altogether unpleasant sadness, "Give it up, sub-subs! For by how much the more pains ye take to please the world, by so much more shall ye forever go thankless. Would that I could clear out Hampton Court and the Tuileries for you. But gulp down your tears, and high aloft to the royal mast with your hearts, for your friends who have gone before are clearing out the seven-storied heavens, and making refugees of long-pampered Gabriel, Michael, and Raphael against your coming. Here you strike but splintered hearts together, there you shall strike unsplinterable glasses." Extracts. Quote, "And God created great whales." Genesis. Quote, "Leviathan maketh a path to shine after him. One would think the deep to be hoary." Job. Quote, "Now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah." Jonah. Quote, There go the ships. There is that Leviathan whom thou hast made to play therein. Psalms. Quote, in that day the Lord, with his sore and great and strong sword, shall punish Leviathan, the piercing serpent, even Leviathan, that crooked serpent, and he shall slay the dragon that is in the sea. Isaiah. Quote, and what thing soever besides cometh within the chaos of this monster's mouth, be it beast, boat, or stone, down it goes all incontinently, that foul great swallow of his, and perisheth in the bottomless gulf of his paunch. Holland's Plutarch's Morals. Quote, the Indian Sea breedeth the most and biggest fishes that are, among which the whales and whirlpools called balaena take up as much in length as 4 acres or arpens of land. Holland's Pliny. Quote, scarcely had we proceeded 2 days on the sea, when about sunrise a great many whales and other monsters of the sea appeared. Among the former one was of a most monstrous size. This came towards us, open-mouthed, raising the waves on all sides, and beating the sea before him into a foam. Tooke's Lucian, The True History. Quote, he visited this country also with a view of catching horse-whales, which had bones of very great value for their teeth, of which he brought some to the king. The best whales were catched in his own country, of which some were 48, some 50 yards long. He said that he was one of 6 who had killed 60 in 2 days. Other, or Ochther's verbal narrative, taken down from his mouth by King Alfred, A.D. 890. Quote, and whereas all the other things, whether beast or vessel, that enter into the dreadful gulf of this monster's, whale's, mouth, are immediately lost and swallowed up, the sea gudgeon retires into it in great security, and there sleeps. Montaigne, Apology for Raymond Sebond. Quote, let us fly, let us fly. Old Nick, take me if it's not Leviathan, described by the noble prophet Moses in the life of the patient Job. Rabelais. Quote, this whale's liver was 2 cartloads. Stowe's Annals. Quote, the great Leviathan that maketh the seas to seethe like boiling pan. Lord Bacon's version of the Psalms. Quote, touching that monstrous bulk of the whale or orc, we have received nothing certain. They grow exceeding fat, insomuch that an incredible quantity of oil will be extracted out of 1 whale. Ibid, History of Life and Death. Quote, the sovereignest thing on earth is parmaceti for an inward bruise. King Henry. Quote, very like a whale. Hamlet. Quote, which to secure no skill of leech's art mote him avail, but to return again to his wound's worker, that with lowly dart dinting his breast had bred his restless pain, like as the wounded whale to shore flies through the main. The Fairy Queen. Quote, immensest whales, the motion of whose vast bodies can in a peaceful calm trouble the ocean till it boil. Sir William Davenant, Preface to Gondibert. Quote, what spermaceti is, men might justly doubt, since the learned Hosmanus, in his work of 30 years, saith plainly, nescio quid sit. Sir T. Brown, of Spermaceti and the Spermaceti Whale, vide his V.E. Quote, like Spencer's Talus, with his modern flail, he threatens ruin with his ponderous tail. Their fixed javelins in his side he wears, and on his back a grove of pikes appears. Waller's Battle of the Summer Islands. Quote, by art is created that great Leviathan, called a commonwealth or state, in Latin civitas, which is but an artificial man. Opening sentence of Hobbes's Leviathan. Quote, silly mansoul swallowed it without chewing, as if it had been a sprat in the mouth of a whale. Pilgrim's Progress. Quote, "That sea beast, Leviathan, which God of all his works created hugest that swim the ocean stream." Paradise Lost. Quote, "There Leviathan."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.